All right. Here's our crude oil contract. Quite a number, man. We almost made it to 63 last night.
Yeah.
Missed it by 2.5 pennies. 62.97.50. We're currently trading 62.58. Jumping in here. Let's see. We're going to jump into the commodities. Check out our crude oil. We'll start with. All right. I might have to refresh this, unfortunately, just because I had this up earlier this morning. We're going to refresh that real quick. 2 seconds. Pull up those charts yet again. Okay. Close out, clean that up a little bit. Okay, we're back here. All right, commodity call spreads, crude oil. We'll start with the 11 AMs. So we're looking at the May futures contract. We're trading at 62.58 right now. 62.75 is gonna be a price point we can use for 11 AM. No, let's just price it out because we have a few minutes. So you would have exposure to the bullish side from 62.75. The bullish one being out of the money, so you're just going to be paying some premium, 10 bucks. Bearish spread, which is where this trade's going to be a little bearish bias because you're trading at 62.57. You have exposure from 62.75. So you're paying almost 30 bucks for the bearish one, 10 for the bullish to become a profitable position. A lot easier when you start going to the downside. So it takes on a little bit of a bearish bias for the 11 AMs, but let's see where the noons line up because we might have, going to be the identical trade. So our bullish trade, our bullish spread, instead of 10 bucks, it's going to be about 11, and the market's ticking around as this is moving.
Okay.
And the bearish one, looking at 31, so you're looking, and 42 for noon. Now the market just moved down only a penny or two, so not much more to gain that noon exposure, still though, pretty dramatic to the downside. And I wonder if one of these are going to have 62.50 for a price point.
That'd be the beauty. Yeah.
And there we go. So the dailies, now these are going to be $3. Let me just jump around. Okay, so perfect. These are going to be $3 instead of $1.50. You're only 6 pennies away from basically where you're getting in. Bullish side, that is the one that's going to have a little bit of intrinsic value, 27 bucks. Bearish side is going to be a little bit cheaper because you're out of the money, 22 bucks. Call it 50 on the dot, 50 cents until 2:30.
Right.
And you have $3 of profit potential on either side. You can always close out one side and look to the other.
And you're close to a true volatility trade.
Yes.
Which is pretty sweet.
You're within 7 pennies, and the difference being that the bullish side, that's where you have those 7 pennies of intrinsic value. So you're looking at $50 on the dot at a couple bucks of commission. So you're looking at basically 50 to 55 pennies of movement away from 62.50. So make it easy. Either you got to get to 62 or you got to get to 63.
Right.
To where you start to get into break even.
So let's see what we're looking at here. So bring this oil contract up.
19.
Oh,
20.
There we go.
Jumping around.
Okay, so look at this. It's been crawling up, hasn't it?
Oh, it's quite a number, man. When I saw that it made it within a few pennies of 63.
That was big numbers yesterday. 793,000 contracts yesterday at 62.75.
Yep.
You get light volume today, but yeah.
Quite a number. Go ahead.
Where? Isn't it? No, yeah. You know, we'll see this thing shake out, but it looks to me like it's still going to want a higher price here.
Yeah, I mean, the trend has been. Can you go back to GPO just for the longer term? Because it really has, man. I mean, there hasn't been a stop.
Look at that.
Since, I mean, you can call it here, the trend has been pretty steady at least.
Yes.
From January 9th, right? But man, that December 26th, like the market
just
entirely.
Just like the market.
That's it, yeah.
Just like the market. This is oil's definitely going right with the market. I mean, that's a classic.
Oh, for sure.
That is really a classic.
And we're now back to basically November 6th, exactly, November 7th, that area. Yeah, so we'll see, man.
And then gasoline. So, you know what's interesting is that unleaded gas for all of us, we're kind of lucky here. It has a different chart on it. It's just not set up the same because of the way that it bounced, which is pretty cool.
Okay.
XB1. I'll show you what I mean. XB1.
Now, they had some refinery issues last week, and so that's where gas would kind of separate from the crude, right?
Yeah. And you can see, look, I mean, you're coming into a wicked supply line here.
Okay.
Where the oil contract's not. Like, if you're watching us on Tiger TV, you can see it. If you're not, folks, you're coming into a big congestion zone with unleaded gas.
Yes.
Where oil doesn't have that. You know, the barrels of oil doesn't have it. You know,
it's just like
this clear sailing.
Yeah. Daily, yearly. track. Because remember, we were looking at, and this is where you can see the difference. Remember, we were at November 9th, or, yeah, right, for crude.
Right.
They've had refinery problems. Well, what does that mean? That means that they're not refining it into gas as quickly.
Yep.
That means there's not as much gas in the market. That means there's going to be higher prices for gas. They're not.
And so it's already happened.
That's what I'm saying.
That's what's really
exactly
going on.
That's
it's already happened. You know, we're already at higher prices.
When we saw
the
refinery last week, you had some volatility for sure. So it could make sense, man. We get those numbers and 3 minutes.
Pretty wild.
It is.
Welcome back, folks. Inventories, we got lots of oil.
We sure do, man. We got inventories rising 7.24 million barrels, quite a number. Gas inventory is actually falling 1.78. Checking back to the market. And we are, come on, trading lower for sure. Quite a drop. We spiked all the way. Let me just blow this up even a little bit.
62.10.
Yeah, 62.10. Now, to refresh, we were trading, and you can see we actually dipped below 62.50. Interesting. We started talking about this. We were trading at 62.58. By the time we got into the news, we were trading at 62.45. And boom, we dropped. You'd expect on that type of a miss to the upside, no matter what the analyst estimate. Just checking back. We saw Bloomberg estimate had a stockpile gain of 700,000 barrels. I saw a decrease number on some of the estimates we were looking at before. So either way, price, not too big of a reaction so far, though,
no,
right?
It's rejecting lower price right now. This is going to be interesting watching this shake out.
It sure is. We hit 62.08. We're trading at 62.30. The market fighting to figure out where it wants to go. And we'll get the full update. It's usually even a little bit quicker. They might try and be trying to digest.
I'll tell you something, folks. If, in fact, this market even stays flat with a number like this, watch out.
Give it a few seconds. We're going to be there.
That would mean that, you know, this thing can really get some power underneath it, which would be,
I would agree.
Which would be a bummer.
Hey, higher prices coming at us for sure.
Exactly.